Welcome back, everyone, to the official Quantum Resistant Ledger channel, your video portal into post-quantum digital asset security. For this video, we're going to do a walkthrough of our mobile wallet. This is going to be the QRL wallet that can be downloaded either from Google Play or from the Apple Store. In this case, I'm going to do the demo from the Apple iPhone because that's the phone that I have. We're going to go through creating a wallet, backing up a wallet, sending some funds, just kind of some basic walkthrough information. And without further ado, let's get going. Okay, so here we have the Quantum Resistant Ledger mobile wallet. And this is the opening splash screen. You have a few different options here. You can do create a wallet, create an advanced wallet, or open an existing wallet. So let me describe the differences here. If you do create default wallet, that's just going to be giving you the default settings for a basic wallet. I would say this would work for probably 90% of people. For those of you that are a little more advanced and want to fine-tune the XMSS Merkle tree just a little bit more, you can actually select a tree height with this advanced option. And what that gets down to is the number of one-time signatures that you can use, essentially how many times you can send a transaction from the wallet. Now, if you're not familiar with one-time signatures and Merkle trees, we cover some of that in previous videos. That'll be a little bit more apparent. This is one of the costs of doing something post-quantum secure, in that there's some trade-offs with how usable something is in order to make it provably quantum secure. So for 90% of people, I would just select that create default wallet. If you want to open an existing wallet, you can open it up here with a mnemonic phrase or a hex seed value. Now, here's the interesting thing. When you create a wallet, either on here or on the website, your wallet is actually tied to the mnemonic phrase and through a mathematical function. In other words, I can create a wallet here on the mobile app and get the password phrase for it. And then I can take that same password phrase and I can use it to open up the wallet on the QRL website through the web wallet. Same thing applies with the hex seed. The mnemonic phrase and the hex seed are mathematical representations of the wallet. So that's a really important takeaway. As long as you have the mnemonic phrase or hex seed value, you can restore your QRL funds from any wallet anywhere. This is the same type of concept that applies to the hardware ledger wallet. Whereas the passwords or the pins, none of that is really important because all of that usually applies to just that installed instance of the wallet. What really matters is that mnemonic phrase or that hex seed value. Okay, so let's do this. First step, let's say you have an existing wallet that you've already created and you want to import it into your mobile wallet. So I happen to have a wallet here. Now, I do not recommend that you store your wallet in Notepad. Ideally, you would want to use some sort of encrypted hardware device like a Ledger or something like that that would generate your wallet for you. Or there's also hardware wallets that are literally made out of steel. There's lots of secure ways to do this. Never send your phrase like this, clear text in an email, or store it like you're seeing here. We're just doing this for a demo. So if you look here, okay, so here is the mnemonic phrase, and we're going to go into the QRL wallet. And as I said, I created that wallet on the website, and we're gonna open it with the mnemonic phrase. I'm just going to paste that phrase into here, and let's create a pin, 8855, and it's important to realize that this pin is specific just to this wallet's installation. It doesn't tie the pin to the actual funds or the wallet itself. It's just for this program that's executing right now. And we'll give this a name. Click return and we'll open the wallet. So I'll give this a moment. Okay, so as you can see, I've imported the wallet from a website, from the QRL website. This should give you a good idea in that the mnemonic phrase is actually the wallet mathematically. And thanks for watching. Hopefully that was helpful as far as a feature walkthrough for the QRL mobile wallet. If you liked what you saw, go ahead and smash that like button and subscribe to our channel. You're also free to visit us at www.theqrl.org or visit our vibrant Discord channel. And all the social media links can be found on the website. Until then, see you in the next video.